3D character art, rigging and animation, interface design, widgets programming, materials programming. Hi there! I'm really excited to share a project that I've been working on for the past year. It's a comprehensive tutorial that covers everything you need to know about creating modular characters. We will create a character consisting of 10 modular clothing and body parts. But that's not all. You will be free to customize each piece with colors and texture patterns to your liking. This project has been quite extensive, so I will strive to create a clear and easy structure to help us all navigate it smoothly. I will explain my approach to character modularity without going into technical details and intricacies. Instead, we will break down the future project step by step. To begin with, I'd like to highlight two types of modularity implementation. Characters with fully replaceable pieces of clothing, like in The Sims 4. The jacket and the undershirt are considered a single model. So when we replace this part of clothing, it changes entirely. It is impossible to only change the undershirt model or remove it and leave just the jacket. However, it's possible when clothing is implemented in layers, as seen in Paralyze. In our project, we will be using the first approach, because it's easier to do and makes everything simpler to understand and work with. Now, where should we start? It can be pretty challenging to figure out how to approach such a big and complex project. We can divide the project into different types of tasks. 3D character art. We'll start by creating the basic body structure. Then we'll explore how to seamlessly connect the modular parts. Next, we'll decide on the number of modular parts. And finally, we'll create several complete clothing sets. I will be sculpting in Blender and texturing in Substance Painter. Rigging and animation. I plan to create a character that can be used with standard animations in Unreal Engine. To achieve this, we'll create a skeleton identical to the one used in Unreal Engine. We will explore different methods of rigging our character in Blender, including a free method and using a paid add-on. Afterward, we'll import our rigged character into the game engine and ensure the animations work flawlessly. We'll even make some tweaks to the code to ensure that AutoIK works with different proportions. Interface design. I will explain and show you how to plan and create a simple stylized interface. I will be working in Photoshop, but remember, you can follow along using any image editor, since I will be using standard features. Widgets programming. This is perhaps the most challenging and extensive part of our project. In these parts, we'll focus on creating and customizing widgets. We'll use data tables to help us organize and display all the existing items in our project. Materials programming. We'll create and customize materials that add color and texture to our character. We'll cover two types of materials, basic and more advanced ones. These materials will enable us to change colors and textures on the modular parts, giving our character a unique look. Now, let me tell you a little bit about the order in which these videos will be released. I understand that everyone has different interests, so I'll make sure to mix things up by covering topics from various categories. For example, we might start with character art, creating a fantasy set of clothing. But instead of waiting to finish sculpting an entire set, we will jump right into customizing materials in Unreal Engine after completing just one item. I want to keep things exciting and follow a logical progression in our pipeline. Thank you so much for your attention, and I hope you're excited! See you soon!